Yes, ladies and gentlemen, tankers of Blitz Universe, welcome to an updated Grille 15 review. There is one already on the channel, and, well, in terms of gameplay, it's pretty much practically the same. But then again, the Grille was nerfed significantly in update 4.2, so I decided to take another look at how to play this tank for a bit. And I've had big fun in it. So to start off with the question, is it a useless tank destroyer now? No, it isn't. Because apart from all these nerfs that happened in update 4.2, this is still a very, very good tank. You just have to play it with more care than you did before. I mean, armor just isn't there. I'm not going to show you any views from Armor Inspector because it's completely irrelevant. Anything that will hit you will go through, except maybe for, well, a slightly lucky shot on the tracks. You have a small Penta style hull. You might be able to catch the occasional HE shot or AP on your track as you move around, but most of the shots will go through and you are very, very vulnerable to HE penetrations. Then again, you've seen it from that shot I did on the Leopard. You have a 15 cm gun with a very long gun barrel, 63 caliber gun barrel. And in that regard, yeah, you can do a lot of module damage as well. And you are, in my opinion, the king of snapshots of tier 10 tank destroyers. More on that later as we get to the statistics pages in armor, on Blitz Source, not Armor Inspector, Blitz Source Tank Compare. We have one, two small snippets of games in there and a few good first class games and also some different type of gameplay, because it is possible to drive the Grille as I am doing now here on Mirage, and that is to drive it as a sort of medium, driving it around, going to a flank, keeping an eye on the minimap, see what's happening in there, and then go to positions where you can put a 640 alpha gun to good use. And that's what I'm doing now here. You can see I am a bit wary of that E100. He has the big derp gun. He can do very nasty things to me. He would probably go in dry, no lube whatsoever. But I can do nasty things to him as well, as you can see, because I have a good gun and I'm driving around. I have my map knowledge. He has overextended. And I'm now using the ridge over here to hide myself and then through his drive wheel. No problem whatsoever. No questions asked. We take the second kill on the game. Bit lucky on the shot on the ST here. There we go. He is turning his turret. No, I can shoot the hill. Thank you very much. And almost an upwards into that IS-8. So this is one way of playing the Grille. There will be another game on this video on Canyon, where I am using the mobility of the tank because it's still mobile. You can see the really quick speed it had before update 4.2. That one is gone. It's now a bit less. You don't traverse as quick as you used to. So yeah, in that regard, you should really be careful on how you play the Grille. But then again, this tank is a tank destroyer. It is a sniper. You have to use it at a range, and you have to be, in my opinion, fairly map aware and see what is happening around you, because if you don't, you will be in dire trouble, and I mean really dire trouble. So without any further rambling along, which I can really do about tanks, let's go into the stats and numbers using Tank Compare on blitzstars.com. And I've lined up all of the tier 10 tank destroyers here. The Grille from the AMX, then all the way to the right towards the Jagdpanzer E100. And if you look at this over here, you can see that the Grille is only exceeded by the 263. He is not the top in class, the Grille. He's second in class in terms of DPM. The 263 gets more. But you have a solid 640 alpha gun, AP at heat shots, HE shells in there. And one thing to notice is that by far, and I mean it's a really, really large margin, the Grille has the quickest AP shell, 1350 shell velocity. That means you can really do snapshots. And you've seen a small example of me shooting that that E75 in there. Aimed down really quickly, shot him through his drive wheel. He had no chance of moving around whatsoever. And that's another thing you can see. Look at the aim time. On the right side, it's all really reddish pinkish. It's not just slightly pink, so you're just a bit better than one of the tanks like it is on. Where we're looking at the rate of fire and the reload. But it's really good. You are far better than all of the other tier 10 tank destroyers in that regard. Dispersion upon movement and rotation is a bit disappointing in my opinion, because I would have wanted a more stable gun platform than the Grille is now. But looking at this, well, it's a made-up design, of course, but it's a very big gun on a very small chassis. So in that regard, it kind of holds out, and it would otherwise make the Grille maybe a bit more too powerful, just a bit too powerful on moving around. It can move around fairly easily, not the quickest one, because the AMX is a fairly good one as well, but it's a goodie tank in that regard, except one thing. Obviously it hasn't got any armor whatsoever. I mean, look at the hull armor, it just isn't there. I think an MS1 with HE shells on a 45mm gun can do really bad things to you, and he could just sit behind you and shoot you all day long, and you would not be able to live to tell the tale. So yeah, wrapping up all these bits, you have good mobility, you had excellent mobility, but now it's just very good mobility. You have a great gun with a huge shell velocity. So all in all, everything on this tank cries out sniper, sniper, sniper. Don't go with this one into the front line thinking, oh, I've got a 640 Alpha gun and I've seen Pushka, Skittic 3, Martin, Anon, whatever, do really good things with it. The Grille has been nerfed. It is still very powerful, but it isn't as swift and quick, especially on traverse, as it used to be. Then again, if you are on, for example, Middleburg, and you see the B-cap running, and you're looking at a team's lineup, and you see that medium's up over there, and the B-cap is still running, then you might think, oh, okay, take the Troy spawn in town, there might just be a red Grille over there. And lo and behold, there he is. Open the ammo selector, kaboom! 1200! There we go! Let's finish him off. Let's switch back to my 640 Alpha gun. And then we're aiming. Aim time. Go, 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 go. Bugger. Leave 6 hit points on him. You whack him for a full roll of 1200 HP on your HE shell, and then you leave 6 on him after you shoot him with a 640 Alpha shot on the AP. Then again, this also shows one of the vulnerabilities of the Grille. I mean, in open field, you would usually get whacked pretty quick, and a T62 is doing a good thing, but I managed to shoot him anyways. He gets a low roll on me, and I just about escaped with 9 hit points left. But yeah, you are a sniper tank, and you don't have that quick shell velocity on HE, but you do have a good gun, and it's good enough to do really big shots like this, 1200 maximum damage. This one is on mines, as you can see, and on greens and on reds were platoons that involved players of Mate. And Mate is a fairly good clan on the EU server. You've seen him in my footage of the Twister Cup finals and the preliminaries. And yeah, one of them is rolling towards the middle. He is holding the line on towards the hill, as you can see, and he's just spotting. We didn't have this bat chat on the line. We didn't have a medium, so I didn't want to go in there, because if I would have gone in there, 3 shots from the bat chat, they have an AMX-5120, a Jagdpanzer E100, a Death Star in platoon with an M48 pattern, good view range. This is a game where I am playing the Kambush style waiting game. I'm holding the line here. I'm looking at the lineup, at how the teams are laid out. I know the Death Star is at the back of red team. We have 2 Jagdpanzers of our team. There is still a Grille somewhere to be spotted. Yes, I've noticed him now on the minimap. You can't see me watching the minimap, but I know I can't shoot the Grille yet, so he's off the radar now. That's a bit unfortunate. So we might as well try to go forward just a tad. Can we shoot the pattern? No, not available. So I'm just sitting here. You can see I wasn't going to turn to try and shoot the pattern, because that would give away my camo rating and my camouflage net. And now is the time to go forward just ever so slightly and try to spot the red Grille again. Where is he? There is he. Thank you. There we go. 631 into you. First blow done by me, that's all well and good. I now have a problem, because they know where I am, and although I have support, it's probably on me to take out the red grill. So I'm still on the fence, sitting on the fence, doing the waiting game, really. You can see I'm wiggling back and forth, he's not being spotted. Pattern available, no, that's one of the Hapke clan, very good clan on EU as well. IS4 is one of Mate's clan, and they are just spotting each other. They are not giving anything away, and they will not, there won't be any easy targets. So what I'm going to do now is poke out just ever so slightly, and only just a very, 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 very tiny bit. And then you can see what I meant in a few seconds by, well, you might catch the occasional shot on your tracks. I mean, I'm not catching it on my tracks, I'm not bouncing shots in the grill, but what I am doing here is just realizing I'm getting shot, driving back, and he was shooting HE. I mean, if he had penned me, then it would have been more, it would have, wouldn't have been 450. He shot me, it was only splash damage, but look at this shot at the accuracy of the gun. He isn't available over there, the red grill, but he makes a mistake by making himself known, and there we go, kaboom, 1040, thank you very much. He is in dire trouble now, he's a one shot to anyone shooting HE, and I'm wiggling back to make him shoot. Yes, he is shooting, thank you very much, that means I have you on the reload. No, not available there. So what we're gonna do now is just drive back, drive back, drive back, just a bit more, drive back, thank you, bushes over there. Going forward again, wiggling back and forth, going forward again. Am I spotted? No, I'm not spotted anymore now. So you will probably think I'm going back to my original position. I'm going to play the waiting game. And I'm going to shoot you. Wait for it. Wait for it. Hello. Goodbye. Thank you very much. We've won the game so far. You can do this in the grill. You can do this in partly any really any tank destroyer. But having the grill with that rear mounted gun, I mean, it isn't a rear mounted turret, it's a gun with a gun shield on a chassis. But with that rear mounted gun, you can really hang it over the sides of your tank, using the maximum gun onto the left and the right to get just a bit more cover and getting those snapshots off. This one is a goodie as well, I think. No, it's not on the MX. Oh, we're going to shoot the FE then. There we go, onto the side. Thank you very much, no questions asked. And we're going to win this game. And it's, well, this is one way of playing the grill. Really sitting there, Cambush like a boss, and this is using the quick shell velocity of the game. I knew that FE would probably pop out to try and shoot me, and I know I would, yeah, I would be able to shoot him back quickly enough. So we've had the drive like a medium game, we've had the Cambush sit at the back and be a bit of a scrub feasting on your teammates game. This one is a bit of a mix of things we have already seen now, and that is being the flanker. I was thinking, oh, I might as well go into C, try to cap it. We have captured it, so that's all well and good. We're raising the pressure. We are well spread out, and reds are also spread out, but just a bit less. So I'm trying to get some easy shots in. Here we go. Track shot. But please scroll back and take a look at that shell velocity. Because I wasn't doing any damage to the tank, but if you look at what's happening over here, take a look, aim in, quick, 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 shoot him, and just as I press the fire button, almost instantly that T-124 gets hit. He quickly repairs as well, so yeah, that's a bit of fortunate, we're not getting any assistance damage, but you can see how quick the gun is if you shoot AP, and if you are map aware and looking around at what's happening at shooting tanks properly. We can now shoot this E50 over there. Again, very quick aim time into the top right hand side of his tank. The Leopard is shooting me as well, that's good. But this again, look at his quick shot in there. He's driving backwards, should have driven forwards. But yeah, okay, happens. And here's another pro top tip on Leopards. Shoot above the tracks with HE, whack them through the sides, and your fires. You do 900 on average damage with an engine fire and some high rolls. You can do really nasty things to those tanks. Again, quick shot on the E50M, you can see it over there. And I was thinking, okay, I got myself well covered behind this, behind the little train station over there. But the E4 over there on the left, he was doing a great job. Excellent shot by him. This one goes into his engine, 622 damage. And we're just rolling around over here and really, really doing the business. E4 is still over there left. That means we can now put the mobility to use. So this is a mix, really, of the first game, bit of a waiting game, and then putting some really good shots in across the map. 640 Alpha, switching to HE to maximize damage output. And there's an E4 over there, it's an American tank destroyer. Americans have big radiators at the back, so I'm switching to HE again. He has problems with his turret, and luckily he decides to show his radiator. So we're going in dry, he needs to grab a pillow, and he's done and dusted for. Unluckily, I got shot by the IS-7, but then again, take a look again, shell velocity. RNGs is well with me, but here we go, lovely little snapshot on the back of the IS-7. Thank you very much. 7-2 win. So in that regard, this was an easy win, but this was putting mobility of the grill to use, capturing C, raising pressure, and then flanking around like a mother buzzer. And if you do 4.8k damage, getting a first class, a few shots at long distance, I think this is a very solid game. Fellow community contributor Matty69 has a, what is it, 6.something k, above 6k damage game in the grill. He was also curious to seeing if it was a useless tank destroyer now, and he practically came to the same conclusion as I'm doing. This is not a useless tank destroyer. You have to adapt your gameplay a bit if you had the grill before earlier, but if you are on the line now, well, you haven't driven the grill in the old configuration yet, so I don't think there will be really big adjustments to how you have to play the tank. The waffle might be an easy one, a more versatile one to use, because it has a fully traversable turret with wonky gun oppression. That's one thing I have to say about the waffle. But this is still a good tank destroyer. It just doesn't get to positions as quick as it used to. That's one thing to take into account. And obviously the gun arc left and right, because, yeah, I mean, 50 on the left, 50 on the right was far better. And upon saying this, I realize that Blitzstars have it incorrect. It should read 35, not 50. But I'm setting up the tank here, as you can see, all the way into the corner, trying to cover C. I am parking the front of my tank towards the building so I can drop down and get into cover if needed. No shots available on the Leopard PT. Okay, they can capture C whatever they want, no problem whatsoever. We have most of the tanks over here. And I'm just going to sit here at Castilla. And I am already turning the tank, as you can see, towards perceived threats from the left. Map awareness, ladies and gentlemen. They've captured C. They are either going to push towards B with those tanks, or they are flanking through our spawn. So that's why I'm already setting up to get cover from the house on the left. You can see it over here. I'm checking my angles. Again, turning my tank already. It's all pre-planning. It's experience. I know if I'm spotted from my left-hand side, that's why I'm zooming in and out as well from the AMX-50B. There he is. I'm going forward so I can get into cover behind it. There's an object 268 down there as well. I'm shooting the 50B now. There he goes. I'm not spotted, surprisingly, but hey-ho. I don't care. I'm not spotted. The Bedshed is rolling in like a mother buzzer. He's going to be a bit angry at me and aggravated, but I don't care. We're going to shoot the next tank available, and that's what I'm also trying to do in this game. Just shoot tanks as they become available, and really prioritize targets left and right. Trying to get shots in on any odd tanks around A-cap, but I wanted to take out some more tanks. I'm only spotted just now, so that means the camo rating of this tank is still phenomenal. Meh on that roll on the MX-50B, leaving 4 hit points. Why? And again, prioritizing targets. That FE can't one-shot the 268, but between the two of us, 640 Alpha plus 640 Alpha means 1280. Yes, we can take out that tank, so no problem whatsoever on that regard. There is a very low health 54E1. Could have switched to HE, but didn't want to because he was presenting his side. Probably would have done splash damage, but hey ho. There we go. We are loading HE on the 50B, but he gets taken out just before we can shoot him at a 268. That means we shoot him, but don't get the kill or the damage. Reds have two bases running now, but only one tank left. And that's the Jagdpanzer E100. So yeah, I am going in. I'm spotted. That's unfortunate. But I'm going in over here because I know he will have problems trying to roll around. If he had rolled forward to me, I would have gone towards that bush indeed, at which I'm pointing the gun. So all in all, pretty solid game until I realized, oh my god, there is a Jagdpanzer over there. So I'm dropping down just quick enough, shooting through the lower glasses plate, no problem whatsoever on that regard. So, final verdict, after all this rambling about on tanks, is it still a good tank destroyer? Yes, it is, in my opinion. Do you have to play it wisely? Yes, you have to play it wisely, but then again, you have to play any tank in World of Tanks Blitz wisely. If you don't play tanks wisely, why play at all? But it's just my thinking. I thank you all for subscribing to the channel. Please support us on Patreon if you haven't already. I do appreciate all the support, financially or just by sending in comments or whatever. Videos that are upcoming will be on the T110E5, on the Leopard 1, which is hopefully the next one I will review. And for now, I greet you, I say cheers and happy tanking as per always, and I catch you on the next one. Ladies and gentlemen, Tankers of Blitz Universe.